share a few words? You need our clarification. Yes, welcome.
About 4 months ago, I broke my left eardrum, and I'm going to tell everybody how not to do this. If you have showered and take the shampoo out with your little finger, you can break your eardrum. So I've been having a hearing loss ever since then. Doing this last exercise, I felt a lot of moisture in there, extreme itching, and I was able to raise the frequency of my voice, and so I knew that my hearing was returning to that ear.
Mm. That's nice.
Initially it was difficult, especially in the fourth stage where you breathe out and hold. First few times I couldn't. I had to breathe in. But subsequently, when I got used to it.
Actually, if you can do that, the whole gear will be shifted to the second level body. Yes.
Swami, in this pranayama,
it's not actually pranayama.
But at least if you hold it too long, the whole cycle changes. Mm. So can you just do it slowly and just make it, set it properly?
No.
No.
Actually, it is just your mental thoughts playing the game. Your mental setup, the whole thing is designed just to break the mental setup of regular breathing. You have an idea, frame about your regular breathing. When that is broken and shaken, you enter into the subtle body. You enter into the dream body. It is just to push you. It's actually the instruction which I gave. You can never do breathing according to that.
I know, it's not, because if you hold it too long,
you can never do that. But try to do that.
Then you breathe quickly because you just cannot do it.
See, you cannot do, but do what I say. It will lead you to that. It's actually purposely created such a way. The very trying will push you into a different consciousness, altered state of consciousness. For that, you are asked to do this. You cannot do this, but do that. It's a technique to push you into that altered state of consciousness. Put your whole effort to do what I said. Then you will see, you will fall into that altered state of consciousness. You will not succeed in what I said. Please understand. You will not succeed in breathing as I said. No, it will never happen. It will never happen. But you will start falling into a different altered state of consciousness. The mood and the energy, whole thing will change and you will fall into different tune. That is what I actually wanted.
My second point is, probably 90% of your meditation techniques requires time that's close to the eyes. And it helps, I know that. But they can be done without it, most of the cases. Why the insistence on
this? One thing, our mind is so restless. If it is not tied, at least one moment you will have a temptation. If you hear some sound suddenly, tap, top, you will just open your eyes and see again, you will close your eyes. You will close your eyes again. But for one moment, if you hear a small sound, tap, that falling, you will one moment open your eyes and see. To avoid that only, I insist on time. And one more thing, the unnecessary light fluctuation will not be there. That is the reason I purposely
tell you this. How does the hunkar expel the fears and certain things?
Now let you understand a small thing. As I was telling you today morning, if you don't do any physical work, just sit and get stressed out, you will have a shoulder pain. If you have just simply some worries, you will have a stomach problem. All your emotions can be reduced to some part of your body. It can be rooted at some trace, the root can be traced at some part of your body. So this hunkar directly brings the dirt from Muladhara and Swadhisthana. It just directly opens up and evaporates it. This can help tremendously to reduce the emotion attached to the fear and the desire in the dream level, because the conscious shift will happen in the 20 minutes. In the 20 minutes of us shifting time, the conscious shift will start happening. The process will start happening and your logic will come down. you will come to such a frequency, you will enter into the zone of that subtle body zone. So when you open up in the subtle body zone by Hunkara, all those things will start getting evaporated.
So they are not situated in the particular?
No, 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 surely not. No, no, only in the Muladhara. Even with scientists, I have explained, they say, Swamiji, the idea which you are giving is something extraordinary. We think we can do some research. We are planning to do some research. Because they came up with the experience, the doctor with whom I was talking, he says, I came up with an experience, Swamiji. If a person gets disturbed in, if he undergoes any accident related to this portion, easily his memory is disturbed, then is this portion. If the injury happens in the head, it takes little more time to lose the memory. But if the injury happens in Muladhara region, very easily he loses the memory. So he says there is some connection between my experiences and your experience. Your thing is in this field, neurology field, for the last 30 years. He says, I also have a doubt, Swamiji. This portion plays a major role in our memory. So we may come upon the truth soon. But according to mystics and my experience, it is solid truth. Chitta, the memory is stored only in Swadhisthan and Muladhara.
Is it normal to see some kind of repetitive colors, not really see any objects or anything?
That's usual.
Just
usual.
When do we do this? Which part of the day?
If you have the problem with the dreams, problem with sleep, deep sleep, do it before you go to bed. That's good.
Can we do this on a daily basis?
Yes, you can. You can.
Can we minimize?
But when you want to do every some meditation technique every day, take up Mahamantra and Dukkaharana. That two are preferable because that two are more powerful. They touch more deeper layers than all these things. This course itself is just an introduction course. It's a introduction that actually in India I don't do this course. Acharyas do it. It's an intro to meditation. There's a second level course, Ananda Spurana, Nityananda Spurana. Only that two courses I do. Take up meditation from Ananda Spurana. There is a meditation technique called Mahamantra. Take up that meditation. There is a, I think, CD and DVD available. Practice that if you want to practice every day. Every day practice that. Practicing that technique will give more results than these techniques. These are all introducing meditation to you.
Can we reduce the time from 20 minutes to...
No, no, no. No question of altering any technique. No masala. No cutting, editing, pasting, no.
Yeah, but
with any technique.
How do we know?
Use the music. Use the music. No, not timer. Better use the music. There are music tapes available. Use them. Naturally, the altered state of, you see, if you have too much of load in the dream, it means whenever you come out of your dream, you always feel sick. You must be having that problem. Then now you, when you come out of this meditation, you will have it. Then you must do this meditation regularly.
And the head is like heavy.
That's what. Do this meditation. It will release more and more pressure. Till you start feeling lightness, same lightness which you felt when you came out from morning meditation. Till that time, do this meditation because so much of pressure is there inside. It will come out.
Apart from not having this dream, this helps. Does it also help in having good sleep?
Yes. See, dreams are the only disturbance for sleep. Who else is enemy, do you think, for sleep? Dreams are the only enemy. Okay. Yes.
When we did the second part, I felt like collapsing. So that's a sign that it's heavy and I should do this.
Collapsing is good. Nothing wrong.
I felt collapsing even in the first part. I was holding the bag. More in holding without brain.
Yeah,
that stage I couldn't do it.
Actually, the altered state, the when the altar, when the shift happens, you feel like falling.
Swamiji, you talk about technique of converting reality to dream, is this associated with that?
Yes, it is real. It will actually, just you are telling, I feel so much of energy being unleashed. So I see, whenever the emotions attached to the memory is released, the whole emotion which was locked in the form of fear and the greed will become a creativity, will become energy. You will start expressing the energy in making your dreams into reality. See, all our emotions are blocked in the fear and the greed. That is why you are not able to realize your dreams. When that is unleashed, when that is brought out, naturally you will see the whole energy will become into a positive energy. And see, if a leaf falls down and if it becomes one with the mud, it will become a manure. Just like that, if the desires or the unnecessary emotions attached to the fear and greed, if they fall down and it will become one with the your being, it will become just a manure, positive energy to support your desires into reality. Okay. Yes.
I kept losing my breath and trying to, I had to stop and try and catch my breath, and then I started to get a headache.
Your mental setup. Then if you have the difficulty in that meditation, you must do this meditation. Because this is going to help you. Okay.
Swamiji, I was sweating profusely with water coming.
Yeah.
That's good.
Sweating.